So, I hear you're going to be in Phoenix next month, huh?
Yeah, I am. I'll be at both Phoenix and Homestead, and really excited about it. I think Phoenix is really one of the best races of the year now in the Eliminator round, and
Well, I heard that it's the grandstands are sold out for that race.
they are. It's the fifth year in a row that the chase race in Phoenix has been sold out, which is really exciting news.
And I will be there, and it should be packed. I'll be there all weekend, Friday through Sunday. So it should be a good weekend of
Awesome.
racing, truck racing, and then Xfinity. I mean, it could come down to the championship there for Xfinity. And then, yeah, then the elimination chase race for the final four, the Phoenix should be a good race.
Absolutely, yeah. We're actually we're gonna be on Matt Tiff's truck, the number 51 truck. So on Friday night, you should check that out, and it's gonna be our games.nascar.com truck. And part of our strategy at Dusenberry Martin Racing is to have something for everyone and create, you know, a casual gaming experience for fans that other than us who, you know, like the hardcore console experience. They can play a traditional game like NASCAR Trivia or NASCAR Slots. So we're going to have some branding on that truck and excited about that.
Nice. So it's games.nascar.com, am I correct?
Yeah, games.nascar.com is the URL. And right now we have NASCAR Trivia Tournament and NASCAR Slots, which are two fun games. And I would definitely recommend checking it out and all the viewers check it out. A lot of fun, and if you think you know NASCAR, the NASCAR trivia game can definitely make you a hero or a zero really fast. So
Right.
that's a lot of fun. I was trying to put a high score up on the board before you and I started racing today. So it's pretty addicting.
I will check that out later on. But now I heard that you told me Matt Tiff. Now, did you have any other drivers that, you know, came to you guys and, you know, played this game?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have 45 licensed drivers in our game. So we
Oh,
have a
wow.
relationship with every team and driver in NASCAR. And in addition to that, we have we have some personal service agreements with Joey Logano, Ryan Blaney, and Bubba Wallace. Who,
Nice.
in addition to Matt Tift, and all those guys are working with our development team and giving feedback and playing the game, and we have a lot of fun working with those guys.
Right.
Man, I don't know what is going on with my car.
Yeah, my gosh. I was trying to stay back to not hit you because you're sideways all over the place.
I know, I was trying to gas it up and run into you so that I could slow you down a little bit.
Oh, okay. That's understandable after what I did at Talladega, so. Oh
I'm
boy.
just trying to prevent that. Oh, here we go. Oh, wow. I see how it is. Wow,
I
you're toying with me for that long. Okay, I see how it is. We'll go to a short track next, and the gloves will come off.
Yes. But no, that's pretty cool. It's kind of, I bet it's pretty cool to meet some of the drivers. You know, to
I just wrecked.
have a chance to be with them, and you know, and they check out your company and check out your game and stuff. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, it really is. You know, the drivers are, we want to have an experience that, you know, the drivers can have fun playing and you know, mass market, a normal casual fan can have a fun experience playing. So their feedback is really crucial to us, and it's great to have them involved because it really is all about the drivers.
Right. So yeah, that's pretty cool. I would yeah. So yeah, I'll check it out while I'm at Phoenix as well. I'll check out the truck. I think there was one race where NASCAR Victory Edition was sponsored on the truck. I can't
Yeah,
remember.
that was Chicagoland.
That's what I
we
thought.
had our we had our NASCAR 15 Victory Edition truck in Chicago, and then we had our NASCAR Slots truck in Las Vegas, appropriately so,
Right.
and then we'll have the trivia truck as well. So
What now, the trivia
I
truck is
actually
where? When's it gonna happen? Phoenix?
it will be in yeah it'll be in Phoenix on Friday night.
Gonna have to check it out because I have pit passes for
Definitely.
all 3 days as well, so I'm gonna have to check the truck out.
Awesome. You were able to score some pit passes?
Oh, yeah. I'm actually leaving Thursday night to head over there, and then I'm staying there for the whole weekend, leave on Sunday evening. And, I mean, it's going to be a good time, and definitely would like to check out the truck, and hopefully, like I said, some good racing all 3 days. Should be a lot of fun. Hopefully the weather is good.
I think so. How long of a drive is it to you to Phoenix?
About 7 hours. But yet...
Wow.
The drive, I would say, from here to out there, because you're going to have to go through this long stretch of desert where you're in the middle of nowhere. It's kind of a boring drive, but once you finally hit the town area of Arizona where Phoenix and Avondale and Scottsdale is all that, it's not as boring anymore. So I'll be excited
right.
not get out of that desert or like desert, you know, area.
Maybe I'll let you ride ahead for 7 and then I'll take the lead off a fourth turn.
Yeah. I mean, if you're in a situation where you're side by side with me for the finish, I think after what happened in Talladega, you have every right to turn me if you want.
All right, I'll put that card in my back pocket and use it if I need to on the last lap.
Exactly. Right. Night racing. I like it. So, obviously, a lot of people have been asking on Twitter when the final update is coming out, and you said early sometime next year?
Yeah, so we're going to do a 2016 update right around the time of the Daytona 500, and it will include all the 2016 paint schemes and lineups so that, you know, the correct teams will do it with the correct drivers and updated schemes, and if there's any schedule changes, you know, incorporate that into the update. So,
right.
You know, we feel, you know, for 1999, to be able to pick up Victory Edition in mass market retail with all the schemes that are included, you know, the Miller Lite cars for the first time, and the free update in 2016, it's a pretty good deal to experience NASCAR for under $20.
Right.
So... We put Joey Logano on the cover of Victory Edition, and it's available at Walmart, Target, Best Buy, Kohl's, and in addition to GameStop with the Jeff Gordon commemorative cover. So,
right,
it's a fun game, and it's all over the place.
All right, so looking forward to it right now. I know I probably don't want to go far into detail in here, but any new features that we should be looking forward to?
You know, we are constantly working on a lot of exciting stuff, and it fits right into our strategy. And, you know, for the first time in NASCAR history, there's a video game and interactive entertainment licensee that's 100% focused on NASCAR. So, you know, we're not interested in other forms of racing or in other sports leagues. You know, we wake up every morning passionate to deliver the best NASCAR gaming experience we can. So, there's a lot of really cool stuff in the works, and we listen to everybody who communicates with us on social media, and we love that feedback. And you know,
right.
Our company we encourage that feedback and want to hear from the fans. And every single Twitter comment is you know, it's sent to our CEO. So you know, the decision maker ultimately is hearing what the fans want, and we work hard to respond every day.
Right. So. I mean, I know every once in a while, you know, this is with every gaming company and stuff, but, you know, sometimes you get those negative feedback and stuff. Like, how do you handle all that, and how do you handle all those negative comments of what people are saying, and if they don't like this or they don't like that on some certain game? Do you think about making a decision on changing this stuff every once in a while if it comes down to that?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you know, we're a brand new company, and we started on January 1st of 2016, and we have a commitment to quality, and we want to deliver a quality NASCAR product to the fans, and we're going to be around the sport for a very long time. And I think the hardest critics on our product are ourselves and our own employees, and You know, we strive to make the best NASCAR gaming experience we can. I'm 28 years old now, and I've been a hardcore sim racer since I was 12. And so I've played every single game and iteration of the games, and you know, I want a great experience. And I think, you know, Victory Edition is a step in that direction with the wide variety of paint schemes and the price point and, you know, the free update in 16, and we're only going to look to improve on that going forward with all of our products.
Right, and that sounds good. So, like, you know, you said you just started a new company, and you know, what's your expectations in the future? I mean, are you just looking for some positive feedback? Just hopefully some positive stuff coming out of the newer games, especially if you look forward within the next 5 or 10 years, let's say. So hopefully, I know, like I say, you're still growing as a company. You think that you have high expectations that this could be a long, successful career and a long, successful company of yours?
Definitely. You know, it goes right back to our commitment to quality. And, you know, when you go to the racetrack and you walk around the campgrounds or the grandstands, you'll see everyone's playing games on their phones or their tablets or their computers. And up until this point, they're really not playing NASCAR games. So we want to provide NASCAR quality entertainment to every single NASCAR fan that there is. So whatever type of game you play, you can have a positive NASCAR experience. And that said, you know, the console and PC business is our bread and butter. And NASCAR fans expect a high quality game that can compete with the other sports franchises and AAA titles. So that's what we're working to deliver. And we're confident we have great partners in NASCAR, and we have a long-term agreement with NASCAR. So we're here to stay, and we're here to make a really, really, really positive impact on NASCAR gaming for years to come. We want to set the standard extremely high. We want to be the benchmark that everyone strives for as far as quality experience in gaming.
Right. I've seen the last couple years. I've gone out to Autoclub Speedway, and I see this game, and even with NASCAR 14, I see these games that there's like a booth of simulators, like you can play the game there, and you know, with the steering wheel stuff. And it seems like every time I see I go play that, it looks like everyone's having a good time. Do you ever think about when you're going to tracks, do you think about having a booth area yourself, and maybe like for advertisement, and trying to give people let's say an event wise I should say, like to interact with players that probably has played your game, and try to set stuff up like that?
Yeah, I think that's a fantastic idea. A year ago the Sprint Experience had simulators set up, and I think that we have a strategy for simulators and getting our software into all the nice win again, by the way.
Yeah,
you got me talking and thinking, and then you snookered the win away. I see your strategy now. You just keep me talking and pass. But simulators at track. I mean, it's a great way for a fan that maybe hasn't played, or maybe a fan that isn't a NASCAR sim racer yet. It gives them a chance to have fun with the product. So I think any sort of activation to get our games tried by as many fans as possible is something we're interested in. So we certainly have a presence at the track. I go to about 25 races a year myself.
Jeez.
for various projects, and I'm constantly talking to the fans about what they what they can experience in our games.
I wish I can go to that many races. If I could go to every race on the schedule, I would. But no, that's pretty cool.
It is. Be careful what you wish for. I actually went to every single race on the season in 2013, and it was an experience of a lifetime. But it was also it's a lot of time away from home, and you miss
right.
a lot of events doing that too. So going to 25 is that's a sweet spot.
Right.
But doing the full season is every NASCAR fan's dream, and I'm definitely glad I got to experience that.
Yeah, like I said, I've never gone to Phoenix International Raceway before. It'd be the first time. I'm going next month, and should be fun there. But I always go to like Auto Club Speedway in Sonoma, and planning on trying to go to Las Vegas for the first time. I was gonna go to Las Vegas for the truck race a couple years back, but something came up and I never got to go. But like to go to Las Vegas there. Next year I'm planning to try to go to Talladega. That should be a fun experience. I would like to try to go as many tracks as I could and go to many races, but sometimes with my schedule and stuff, it's just impossible to do that, but it would be fun. I would definitely go to every race if I could.
Absolutely.
So, like I said, looking forward to the new game. Just if you're expecting, if you're estimating here, when are we expecting NASCAR 16 to come out? Like next spring, next summer, fall? What are we looking at?
Yeah, right now we're ultra excited about Victory Edition being on shelves for the holiday season, and Joey being our new cover athlete, and for $19.99 at all the major retailers. That's what we're really excited about now, but we are certainly hard at work at what's next, and we're going to have some exciting announcements coming up, and I'd love to come back and talk to you then, but in the meantime, it's I encourage everyone to pick up Victory Edition and try it out to get the NASCAR experience for $20 on Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3 and PC. It's pretty hard to beat that, the price for that, the experience the game delivers.
Right, so of course the focus right now you want to stay on is NASCAR Victory Edition because it just released. I can totally understand that now. But in the meantime, after you just released that, you're still in the process of working on NASCAR 16 right now, am I correct?
We're hard at work at a ton of exciting projects at Dusenberry Martin Racing, and since we're 100% focused on NASCAR, every product that you're going to see coming out from us is NASCAR related. So, yes, we're hard at work at many, many different projects, and excited to announce a lot of stuff coming up in the next coming months.
Right. I've been trying to follow in on Twitter every once in a while, checking out new updates and stuff like that, even your website. I can totally understand. Right now the focus is on the Victory Edition that just released, but yeah, also the other focus is on NASCAR 16, and then looking forward to when that announcement coming out soon of when the release will be and stuff. But now, for those that don't know, and I've seen a lot of questions about these as well, but if you already own NASCAR 15 and you can download the Victory Edition now, will the update will automatically install into the game, or do you have to buy the Victory Edition separately?
The owners of NASCAR 15 are automatically upgraded to Victory Edition, and from there, you'll also be included in the 2016 update. So, all of our all the NASCAR fans and hardcore gamers like myself that bought the original on May 22nd for $20 at GameStop, and it's still available for $20 at GameStop. But all of us that did that now have the Victory Edition applied to our game.
It's pretty cool. Yeah, because I've been seeing a lot of comments and a lot of tweets about, like, wow, they only brought out one update. How come they didn't bring out the 2016 update? I was like, well, just like maybe a good example like we saw yesterday, because not all teams and drivers have their 2016 schemes announced yet. Just like yesterday with Kurt Busch with the Monster Energy. I mean, you can't really release a 2016 update without all the teams and drivers that has possibly new schemes that they're going to have for next season. So you want to make sure not to release something like that early. And then all of a sudden later on, you have to like add those new schemes into the game. So I can totally understand why the wait is until around, you said, the Daytona 500 next year. You know, and I hope a lot of people would definitely understand that.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head. It's, you know, with the schemes haven't been released yet, we already have our artists hard at work at creating the paint schemes that have been released, and but we just don't have all the information, like you said. You know, what's Clint Bowyer's number going to be next year? Is it 51? Does he take the 15? There's so many unanswered questions. That's why it will be. That's why we'll wait to release around Daytona when everything is final and released and created for the game.
Right, and that I can totally understand, and glad that that can be maybe cleared up for some people. If they're probably watching this video right now, they're hopefully they will understand more why 2016 update is not out. And now, besides the 2016 update, are we expecting maybe any more updates and schemes that are from the 2015 season? If that's so, then would you like to explain to them maybe?
We're gonna focus on next year's schemes for our 2016 update, and we want to keep our game as authentic and accurate as possible. So
right.
Going forward from this point on, all the updates will be 2016 updates. Like, for example, if there's any schedule changes, the 2016 schedule hasn't been released yet. That will be reflected in the 2016 update as well.
That sounds good. That's a good understanding there. So the focus now is on 2016.
For as far as NASCAR 15 Victory Edition updates,
right.
Correct.
Yes. So that sounds good. That's totally understanding now, because I was even wondering that myself too, if you guys were going to release any more schemes that was involved with 2015, but now I see the point of just now focusing on 2016. So that sounds good right there.
Sure.
And now, next generation consoles, we're expecting PS4 and Xbox One to be involved.
You know, like I said, we're working on a ton of exciting stuff, and we'll have some announcements in the coming months on all that. But the future of NASCAR gaming is exciting, and you can take it from me. I'm a diehard NASCAR gamer, and I live and breathe it. So we're hard at work and on quality NASCAR products, and we'll have all those details for you coming soon.
Sounds good. Because yeah, those have also been the questions too. If PS4 and Xbox One, especially when NASCAR 16 comes out, if that was gonna be the case and stuff, and you know, but either way, I'm definitely going to pick up. I mean, right now, yes, the focus on Victory Edition, and I've got to still record more footage about that from it. But also, when NASCAR 16 comes out, looking forward to recording some footage from there, and whatever console is going to be on, really looking forward to the game.
Absolutely.
And like I said, if you ever have the time and if I have the opportunity, I would like to meet you out there in Phoenix. Be a pretty cool experience to. And maybe be an honor to meet you and, you know, talk for a bit. That would be pretty cool as well.
Absolutely, yeah. I'll have Sean give you my contact info, and I'd love to connect with you on pit road and catch up for a little bit.
Yeah, that sounds good. And I also would like to check out that scheme of Matt Tift, because I saw the Victory Edition. I saw the slot. Well, wait, the slot one, that's not come out yet, right? That would be Phoenix?
It has, yeah.
Okay.
The Slots truck ran it at the Las Vegas race, and the Slots game is available on games.nascar.com. And it's like a slot machine, but there isn't money involved. So
okay.
It's an entertainment-only slots game, but
right.
It's a lot of fun. It's really addicting, and it's fun to try to get your levels up and continue to move on up. So that and trivia tournament are really fun games. If you have some time in the office and your boss isn't looking over your shoulder, check out games.nascar.com because it's a fun thing to do.
Right. I got that mixed up. So I'm guessing the Earth scheme for Phoenix is going to be the trivia one, or is it going to be... Okay.
Trivia tournament, correct.
Okay, yeah, I got that mixed up. I thought trivia already ran this up, but no, it sounds cool. I'm looking forward to see what kind of scheme that would be. And hopefully that truck will have a good finish. Hopefully Matt Tiff will run good there. I mean, like I said, I can see him getting a win soon. He seems like he's strong every time he's in that 51 truck. So I'd like to see him get a win. It'd be pretty cool.
Us too. Absolutely.
Now, so like I said, definitely like to meet you out there at Phoenix. Talk for a bit. Get a look at the truck. Get a look at more stuff coming up for the game and stuff. So,
you feel that?
I did feel that. That was pretty close. But, but like I said, there's a chance. We'd like to meet you out there at Phoenix, and be a pretty cool experience there.
Sounds good. We'll plan on it for sure.
Yeah. And, hopefully, I would definitely love if I ever get the opportunity. Now, you said your DMRacing is it's located at the home of NASCAR in Charlotte, right?
That's correct. So, Dusenberry Martin Racing is located on the 17th floor of the NASCAR building. So, we are right above the NASCAR Hall of Fame in Charlotte, and that's really how integrated we are with the sport. So, we have the marketing and communications and licensing teams and NASCAR Productions and the Hall of Fame, all of those resources are right, a few feet away from us. So it's really the most ideal location for a NASCAR video game and interactive entertainment publisher to be located. Because, if we need to talk to somebody in NASCAR, we can just, they're two floors away.
That's a good point of why put the company there. I mean, be right at the hometown of NASCAR, and that's pretty cool to be with NASCAR and be that close to them, especially you just said a couple floors. I mean, that's, and in the area, I mean, that's pretty amazing there. I mean, I was just about to say, if I ever have an opportunity, I would like to come visit out there. I would like to, because I've been always wanting to visit the Hall of Fame anyway. My dad went there a couple years ago because he went for a business inventory over there in Charlotte a couple years ago, and he went to the NASCAR Hall of Fame. I kind of got jealous at him, and I would definitely like to go check out the Hall of Fame, but if I get the opportunity, I would like to come check out DMRacing as well.
Absolutely. If you are in the Charlotte area, you are more than welcome to come by to the office, and we have some simulators here, so I want to challenge you in person to a race as well.
Sounds good. And just took the win there again.
I know.
But I would like to have the opportunity of checking out the company over there, and kind of maybe get a little sneak peek on what I could be looking forward to, and maybe what the fans would look forward to. I think that would be a cool experience.
Yeah, we'd love to have you anytime. Our whiteboards are full of ideas for new features and enhancements and improvements and all exciting stuff. So we'd love to show it to you.
That would be pretty cool. Maybe I'll plan that. I would like to come out there. Because, like I said, I definitely want to check out the Hall of Fame while I'm there as well. Because I hear the Hall of Fame is a cool experience to look at as well. So
yeah, the Hall of Fame is an awesome experience. It's you know, it's awesome for us to have the history of our sport right in our basement of our office, and
right.
It's you know, it's incredible to go look at the cars and appreciate the history, and you know, see how far the sport has come in 60 plus years.
That yeah, that'd be pretty cool. Like, not only will I try to go visit the Hall of Fame and maybe your company, I'd like to visit some of the team shops like Hendrick, and would like to see some other shops like Stuart Haas, Joe Gibbs, Penske. You know, it'd be a pretty cool experience just to look at the shops, Hall of Fame, and like I said, maybe DM Racing. I would like to take a visit.
Definitely. Maybe you know what? When I was 16 years old, my parents wanted to take us on a vacation, and we were talking about where to go, and I convinced them that we should take our family vacation in Mooresville, North Carolina. And I went from shop to shop, getting my picture taken in the lobby and doing the shop tours, and we did a tour of Charlotte Motor Speedway, and I was hooked. It's so cool to be able to see the headquarters of the teams and see them working on the cars, and it's definitely worth a visit, and it's like being in heaven for any NASCAR fan. You know, within 50 miles of our building, 90% of the teams are located, so it's really cool for us, and we make it out to the shops a good bit ourselves to you know, keep our relationship strong with the teams and the drivers, and having them be encouraged about our future and where we are with Victory Edition as well.
That's pretty cool. That, like I said, be probably a cool experience to be out there and checking all the shops and the Hall of Fame and stuff, because I've been wanting to try to do that for a while, but like I said, I mean, I got some open areas on my schedule coming up soon, and maybe if I think about it, maybe I'll plan a trip out there, because like I said, I'd definitely like to check out the area of NASCAR, because since I'm a diehard, yet I've never visited out there, that'd be pretty amazing experience.
Definitely. Well, it's an open invitation to you for Dusenberry Martin Racing. So whenever you can make it out, we'd love to give you a tour and run some races in person.
Yeah, that'd be pretty amazing. So now, what gave you the idea of wanting to start your own company as making these NASCAR games? Like, what gave you that idea? Like, okay, this is what I want to do. Like, when did that start?
Well, I'll give you some background. I grew up in Massachusetts racing. I raced street stocks and late models, and you know, got my career started by playing NASCAR Heat and Dirt to Daytona, and then wanting to take that to the real track. And I came down to High Point University in North Carolina to go to college because I wanted to be in the racing capital of the world. I got a job at the official NASCAR Members Club out of school, which is the official fan club of NASCAR. And then I managed Brad Keselowski for the last 4 years before joining Dusenberry Martin Racing. And you know, so that's kind of my story on how I got there. And the company story, our CEO, Tom Dusenberry, and President Ed Martin go back 20-plus years. And Tom was actually the CEO of Hasbro Interactive, which held the video game license back in 1999 and the early 2000s. And Ed was the executive producer on his game. So those two remained family friends over the years. And when the opportunity to acquire and extend the NASCAR license came up, those two guys got together and made it happen. So Dusenberry Martin Racing was born on January 1st of 2015. So that's kind of the story of the company. And we've been full throttle, literally, ever since, and creating all sorts of fun, quality NASCAR games for fans. So.
That's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool story. I could have sworn I heard about Ed Martin before in those Hasbro games. I just couldn't remember because, one, I haven't played those games in a long time. But I thought Ed Martin was familiar. But, no, that's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool story. And, you know, unlike me, like, I've raced go-karts every once in a while, and I'm just a YouTuber, and you know, went to college for some time, and but yet my goal, my career has just been all on YouTube and stuff, so that's where I've been facing more, and you know, it's just been a successful YouTube channel for me. I just never thought, I mean, it's not like 100,000 or 500 million subscribers, it's not like that, but you know, just more successful than I expected, you know, but you know, whatever whatever life it leads you to, just stick with it, you know, because it could be a successful career sooner or later.
No doubt. That's the plan, hopefully.
So, like I said, maybe I'll try to find an opening of when to visit Charlotte, because that would be a cool experience. That would be a cool experience to go check out the area of NASCAR, the hometown. And, like I said, visit you guys and have a good tour of the place. And, yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Sounds good to us. We are, too.
So, we'll see. I'll look forward to it. Maybe I'll find an opening, and then I'll maybe contact you guys back, and if that's good for you, then sounds good for me, then maybe, who knows, I'll be out there soon.
That sounds great. We'd love to have you, and I'd definitely love to do more videos. I got time for one more race, if that's okay with you.
That's good. That's good, because I was just about to tell you as well, I only have like about 15, 20 minutes left, so this is fine for me here too.
Cool. Sounds good. So let's have this race. This race counts for all the other races. Whoever wins this is the champion of NASCAR.
Oh, sure, even though I've won more, but that sounds great.
Awesome. That works for me. It's for all the marbles.
I say, loser. I'm just joking. Wise loser buys dinner if I visit out there.
Yeah. Loser has to admit to all the viewers of this video that they're not the best driver.
Okay. That sounds good. I mean, I probably don't have to show or say that. They could just know already. That's based on what they could see in this video. No, but now I'm really honored that you guys are a big fan of my channel and stuff, and I'm really glad you guys are supportive of me, and I'm really glad that I get to make gameplays and videos of your game and stuff, and because of that, I'm glad you guys are looking at those videos and just being big fans, and such an honor, because you know, it's amazing to me now these days, now that I have like right now over 21,000 subscribers, that even big companies like you and growing companies look at my gameplays, and just knowing that, wow, they're big fans, it's pretty amazing. It's just like, wow, I never really thought where I have brought myself to today.
Yeah, well, we really appreciate you playing our games and having so much fun with them, and you know, we always have time for fans of NASCAR gaming, so we are as equally as appreciative for you taking the time to talk to us.
Right. And yeah, it was like a week ago when I got the message that you guys wanted to contact me and talk to me, it was such an honor. I was really excited. I was looking forward to the day. I woke up this morning and you know, just trying to stay composed, just be ready for the day and ready for this experience, and you know, like I said, such an honor to speak with you guys, and looking forward to the future of you guys' company, and looking forward to not only the 2016 update, but NASCAR 16, and then some more NASCAR games in the future, like in the next few years. So, it's a good time. Ow! Oh my gosh!
Okay. Oh!
It's like, sorry.
I'm looking forward to the future of Victory Lane happening right now. But I definitely, you know, I appreciate it. And do you have something to tell the viewers of the video now?
I would, you know, not much, but you know, I should just tell them, you know, just keep looking forward to. Obviously, they're obviously looking forward to more gameplays of mine on my channel, but they're also looking forward to.
I meant the better driver bet.
Oh, yeah, he's, guys, it's just been confirmed as you looked at this video, I suck. I'm not the best racer in the world, but,
well,
no.
I don't know about that, but, you know, I definitely, I appreciate it. You held up your end of the bet.
Hey, Listen, I can be honest. I don't like to lie to my viewers and stuff, and especially my mother. She doesn't like when I lie, and I never really lie, so I can be honest. But no, like I said, looking forward to it, you know. Looking forward to the future, and looking forward to see what you guys are going to bring to your company and to the NASCAR world and NASCAR gaming in the next few years. NASCAR 16 will bring us, and like I said, looking forward to buying the game and making videos of the games, and like I said, should be good.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for your time, and if you need anything, don't ever hesitate to reach out. We appreciate it.
No problem. I will contact you soon, and hopefully, like I said, meet you out at Phoenix International Raceway next month. Or I should say Jeff Gordon Raceway for now.
Jeff Gordon Raceway.
But no, I'd like to look forward to meeting you, and like I said, looking forward to visiting you guys out in Charlotte sometime soon.
Absolutely. Sounds great. Well, have a great night, and I look forward to talking to you soon.
Thank you very much. You have a good night.
All right. Take care.